Hey, what's up everyone? I'm Colby from Sanitarium Productions. We're back again with another G.I. Joe action figure review. In this episode, we're taking a look at the G.I. Joe Retaliation G.I. Joe Tactical Ninja Team set. This came out in 2012 as part of their little miniature box set wave here. So there were two different sets here. This one and the Cobra Invasion Team, which we'll be getting to in a upcoming review, so be on the lookout for that. But today we're taking a look at the Tactical Ninja Team. So this set comes with three figures. We get Airborne, a Snake Eyes figure, and Agent Mauser, who I don't really remember too much about. But also comes with a working rappelling line, which I guess is code for another zip line, because they love those zip lines in this Retaliation set, so, whatever. This does come on a standard Retaliation branded packaging here. Nice window in the front here, so you can see all the three figures and all the crazy accessories that we got going on in there. The top has just a standard G.I. Joe blurb. The bottom has the additional at the Cobra Invasion Team along with the UPC symbol. The two sides have the standard G.I. Joe Retaliation art. And then on the back, we actually get a nice close-up photo of the three figures and some more stuff about what's going on with the G.I. Joe universe, etc., and the Retaliation movie line. So, Agent Mouse, G.I. Joe Marksman, Sergeant Airborne, the G.I. Joe Paratrooper, and Snake Eyes, the G.I. Joe Ninja. Very cool looking set. So this particular set, I think, is one of the more sought after sets of these three packs from the movie line here. And I think it's simply because it has the exclusive Agent Mouse in it. I don't really know. So if you all have an idea of why this set is so sought after, you know, drop a comment down below, let me know, because that's the only thing I can figure out is that Agent Mouse, and again, I don't really know too much about him, so don't know what the hype is about, but that's okay, don't need to. Got a single piece of tape here on the side, so let's go ahead and cut that off. And yank the tabs open. I did hear something rattling around in there, so I think one of the accessories may have come loose. So we'll look at that here in a moment, but let's go ahead and pull this thing out. It's actually stuck in there pretty good for some reason. There we go. Packaging goes to the wayside. That's what was catching on it. I guess this thing had come unloose and stuck. And there is our little loose bit here. I guess it should have been in here. We'll just kind of stick this back in here. There, that's what you should get in the set. We do also have a cool little instruction book here. Let's take a look and see what it says. G.I. Joe Tactical Ninja Team. To remove vest, pull a little thing, yank his head off, pull the vest off. And then the back side is attached the rappelling line. And it looks like it also can clamp onto the Ghost Hawk 2. That is pretty cool looking. So go check out our Ghost Hawk 2 review if you haven't already. We'll toss that to the side and take a look at here. So the figure plasticky stuff here actually comes taped on, of course. So we got a couple pieces of tape holding this thing on. So let's go ahead and slice that off on the top and the bottom. Flip it back over and just kind of pull that out. Grab on the bottom of this flap and kind of push it through, and it should just lift right out. And voila, our figures are free. And our kind of included display here is this kind of Cobra Warehouse looking thing here. So this is pretty interesting. I do like this one. It actually manages to have that kind of weird 3D effect going on. So that's cool. I like that. But for right now, we're going to toss that to the side as well. And get a closer look at these figures. Pull this piece of tape off because it's aggravating me. Put it back over here somewhere. So, we have three figures and a ton of accessories here, so that's cool. Where do we start? I'm going to flip this over to the back. All the figures actually have these little clear rubber bands holding them in place. So I'm going to start by just cutting those rubber bands off. And one here for Agent Mouse. I think that's it for those. We also have some tape on pretty much all of these accessories. So I'm going to go ahead and cut the tape off of those also while we're here. And hopefully they will come out rather easily. And we won't have too much to fuss about. And one there, one here at the top, one for this little knife. And I think that's everything. Well, let's just go ahead and start yanking stuff out here. We got this cool rappelling line thing. We'll take a closer look at it in a moment, but let's just get everything out here first. Just grab weapon, pull out Agent Mouse, get rid of that rubber band on his arm and his leg. Go ahead and grab this weapon here. And then we've got this little knife up here at the top. And we got a cool helmet for Agent Mouse. Then we have this crazy spiky thing for Snake Eyes. Go ahead and yank Snake Eyes out as well. Get rid of that rubber band off of him. Then we have two of these cool Uzis. We have a pistol with a silencer on it. And we have another ninja claw. And we have the sword backpack. We have Sergeant Airborne here. Let's see, his weapon is stuck in the side there. Pull him out. Get rid of the rubber band. And then we have a cool shotgun thing. We got this cool helmet. And we have two ninja swords. One and two. And that's all we get in this. So we'll toss this to the side. So a lot of cool accessories. A lot of cool stuff here. It looks like Snake Eyes gets the top billing with accessories. And Airborne gets the bottom billing with only a couple of accessories. But anyways, let's see. Let's just start over here on this side and take a look at this thing and see. So this is our rappelling line. And we saw actually this same system basically in the actual Ghost Hawk itself. The Ghost Hawk 2 from the Retaliation line. So be sure to go check out that review if you haven't already. This is slightly different than what we have seen in the past. Basically, you have this little vest harness that attaches to your figures, and then you pull up on this little piece here, and it raises and lowers your guy here. So, for the sake of argument, I'm going to grab our beachhead figure here just to show you how this works. You just kind of snap this in place like that, and then it just lifts up. So it's a kind of cool little mechanism. It doesn't work for all of these characters with their web gear and things like that, so it won't fit on Airborne without taking his harness off. It'll probably fit this guy, though it does say to, you know, remove his vest and everything first, but it kind of fits well enough anyway, so it's kind of latching in place like that, and you can jump off buildings and go up into the sky and all sorts of cool stuff, so pretty cool. The actual pack itself, so it's made as like a backpack, but it has this really interesting kind of clamp system on it. It's on basically a little slider mechanism here, so you just kind of force it to move open, and then you like clamp it to a table edge or something like that, and then clamp it back down and use that as your rappel base, which is kind of an interesting idea. And again, we'll just peg it into his back here. Try to. May have to move his vest around a little bit to get it to line up. But when you do get it to line up, it just kind of latches on like that. And he's a walking rappelling base. So it's interesting. I don't really know how useful it is, but it's interesting anyway. So there's your big, huge rappelling base thing backpack. Moving on, our first figure here to look at is actually Agent Mouse. And let's look at his accessories first. We do have this crazy, like, dull orange color weapon. It's an interesting designed weapon. Some nice detail work on it. Again, I don't know what model of actual weapon this is based off of, so you know, feel free to leave comments down below if you know more about that than I do. You can't know much less about it, so pretty cool looking anyways. We also get this other weapon here, which is the same color. Again, nice detail work. Looks pretty cool. We get a small little knife here, a little boot knife looking thing. Which ends up being kind of too small to do a whole lot with. But I think I saw, yeah, so on the back side of Agent Mouse's harness here, you actually have a little slot there for a knife to fit into. So we're just going to slide this knife right in there, like so. And he can carry that knife with him. So that's actually pretty cool. And get the focus on that. So that's actually pretty cool. Again, I've stated before, I love when you have accessories that match up with holsters and sheaths and things like that. So that's really very cool. We also have a little helmet here for Agent Mouse. This one looks kind of weird. It kind of looks like the helmets from Starship Troopers to me, which is cool if you like that. Very interesting looking. It also kind of looks like a bicycle helmet, so I'm going to choose to, instead of thinking of it as a bicycle helmet, to think of it as a Starship Trooper helmet. So we got our figure here, slide it on over top of his head, and kind of move it around a little bit, and there you go. It's fits pretty well. May have to slide it around to get it to look right on his ears, but it works pretty well for what it is, so it's actually kind of cool. Pop that back off of there. And since we have the figure in our hands, let's go ahead and just look at the figure itself. It does have a pretty interesting head sculpt here. I don't know if it's actually supposed to be somebody specific or not. It doesn't really look like anybody to me, but that's fine. It's got some interesting detail work, like in the hair there, so it's definitely unique. We've seen this tactical vest before with some slightly different color deco, so it does have some really cool detail work in all of that, and it looks good. And again, that knife fits into the back there. We've got kind of the two-tone underside of the shirt going on here, which is a nice little highlight there. Some nice detail work on the rest of the actual clothing and the pants and things like that. So some really nice detail work going on here. Very interesting choices anyhow. Articulation wise, the head does spin 360 degrees. Plenty of up and down motion, side to side tilt, which is very nice. Standard ball and swivel at the shoulder joints. Standard ball and swivel at the elbow joints. We do have a swivel and a rocker here on the wrist. There we go. Very nice. We do have the chest twist feature, which is limited by the actual chest web gear thing here. So you can't really do a whole lot with it, but it's there. No ab crunch that's able to work with that vest. Standard T-hooks at the waist and hips. We do get a double knee joint and a swivel rocker thing at the ankle. So all in all, pretty nice. The figure itself looks really good. I do like the way it looks. I like the kind of generic soldier kind of appearance of this guy. It stands out pretty good. The helmet I'm not really crazy about, but we'll slap it on here anyways. To be honest with you, with the helmet on, it looks like David Duchovny. I don't know why that is, but that's what I'm seeing when I put that helmet on there. But anyways, it's still a pretty cool looking figure. I don't know why everybody is really crazy about it, except that it is a unique character. It's not one we've seen before. So, yeah, there we go. There's Agent Mouse. Moving on, we have Snake Eyes up next with a plethora of accessories. So where do we start with those things? Let's pick up this crazy spiky thing here. Some interesting detail work on it. It works pretty well. You just kind of slide it over top of his hand like so, and then grab it in his hand, and you got your spiky bit. I don't know what the devil it's called, but we do get two of those, one for each arm, so that's kind of cool. We'll throw those to the side there. His other one that he has on his hand right now is this ninja claw. This one is actually painted as opposed to some of the ones we've seen in the past, which were solid colors. So that's nice. Does fit over his wrist pretty easily and looks pretty cool. There are two of those in the set as well. Snap that one into place there. And you've got two cool ninja claws. Rawr, I'm a bear. He's not a bear. Anyways, we'll throw those to the side as well. But they are cool accessories. We do get two ninja swords for Snake Eyes. It's the same swords that we've seen in previous sets. And they actually came with Kamakura in the previous Retaliation Ninja Dojo set. Slightly different color scheme, of course. Excuse me. But some interesting detail work. This one does not have that weird thing on it. The smaller sword actually does have that Arashikage clan symbol etched into the blade there, so that's cool. We also get the same kind of standard sheath backpack for these things. Some interesting detail work on that. It does have the open back on it. The swords just slide in there to the side. And you may have to pop those things around to get them to actually line up correctly. Same thing for the lower sword. And then you just pop that on his back here. Again, you have to kind of hunt to line up the peg hole with the web gear. And once you do that, you can pop that in there like so. And it fits pretty well. Looks pretty good. I pointed it out with the Kamakura figure in that last set. I don't like the way that the open back of that thing looks from the front. Just a personal preference to me, but it's a nice thing. It definitely fits well with the figure. The color scheme works well with all the other accessories with his web gear. So it's a nice little touch there. We do have the cool pistol with the silencer. Again, some interesting detail work for such a small weapon. The actual silencer here, you just kind of pull on it and it removes from the barrel and line it back up and it goes back on there. So that's a nice little thing. On Snake Eyes himself, we actually do have a holster on his side here for that pistol. So we'll go ahead and slide that in there like so. And the silencer piece fits right there as well. Very nice. Very cool. Nice touch there with that. I've always loved the sculpt they use for that particular weapon and accessory. So very good job there. We also get two of these little Uzis. Again, not a lot of detail work, but just enough. The interesting thing about these Uzis is this clip on the backside. And on his actual web harness here, he actually does have the two clip holes there on his side. So you just kind of slide those in there, and he can clip those Uzis to his side, which again is a nice little touch there. End up working very well. So all in all, Snake Eyes can basically carry almost everything in this loadout this time. So very cool. Toss that to the side. The other accessory we have that's actually part of the figure here, on his lower leg, we got a little knife here attached. Very cool. It's just a one tone, no extra paint or anything like that. But we do have that cool holster on his leg there, so that's nice to slide that in there. So very cool. Looking at the figure itself, good things first, I guess. Very nice detail work. It's kind of the basic figure that we've seen underneath. He's got that kind of beachhead body, I guess you could say, because it has that weird striping stuff going on. The Arashikage clan symbol on his side. Some very nice detail work on his face mask. Some very cool stuff on his web gear here. These cool throwing daggers. Some throwing stars up at the top. Standard detail work on all the pants and clothing and everything like that. So very nice looking. I'm just not sure about this color scheme, to be honest with you. It looks just a little weird to me. The gold and the green just don't really scream a whole lot about Snake Eyes to me. So, I don't know. I mean, it works for what it is, but I'm just not really sure about that. So, articulation-wise, the head does spin 360 degrees. We have plenty of up and down motion. We do have a standard ball and swivel at the shoulder joints, standard ball and swivel at the elbow joints. We do have, let's see here, a swivel joint and rocker joint on the wrist. There we go. Standard chest twist, ab crunch motion is there as well. The harness starts to get in the way, but not too bad. Standard T-hooks at the waist. The little pieces on his harness here do start limiting mobility from front and back. It's not too bad though. You can always just pop those little pieces off and unclasp them. Actually, no, you can't. This doesn't, that's not an actual piece you can pop off. So you're kind of stuck with that. standard double knee joint there, and standard swivel and rocker at the ankle. So all in all, standard articulation here, nothing really bad at all. It's a nice figure. Except for the web gear, it's a really cool figure. The web gear, just the color turns me off. But you do have lots of access to add all these accessories and everything to the figure. He can carry about everything, so I don't know, you'll have to kind of go from there. But it's a nice figure, just I don't really like that color scheme. Just me, but that's my opinion. Up next is Sergeant Airborne, or just Airborne as I prefer to call him. We have a cool weapon on his hand here, so let's get rid of that rubber band. Look at the actual small machine gun here. Nice detail work. If I can quit dropping it. Very nice looking. And I'm not going to quit dropping it, so I'm going to put it down. We also have this cool shotgun here. Someone had corrected me before when I said assault shotgun. It's a tactical shotgun, so let's call it that, tactical shotgun. Looks pretty cool, though. Some nice detail work on it also. I like the clip on the side there, or the bandolier for the shotgun shells. Very nice. We also get this cool helmet. We can get our focus to adjust here. So very nice looking, really great detail work. Very cool. That fits over top of his head pretty easily and looks really awesome on the figure here. So yeah, that's cool. I like that. The figure itself has some really awesome detail work going on here. I got this cool breathing tube thing here on the back side. Very awesome detail work all the way around on this guy. Parachute packs, cool pouchy things everywhere, all sorts of crazy gear. Just a very cool paratrooper figure, to be honest with you. The web gear itself is kind of loose and moves around pretty easily, so you don't have to worry too much about it getting in the way. And it does kind of come off pretty easily, pops off like that. There are not really any of those crazy tabby things to kind of worry with, so you can do quite a bit with this guy. Articulation-wise, the head does spin 360 degrees. Got some up and down motion and some left and right head tilt, so that's cool. Standard ball and swivel to shoulder joints. Standard ball and swivel at the elbow joints. Swivel at the wrist. And I don't think we have a rock. Actually, we do. If I can get it to work. We were looking at the wrist articulation on Sergeant Airborne here. And he actually does have a rocker on that wrist there. So that's a cool little added bonus here. You also get the standard waist twist, chest twist, ab crunch motion going on there. The web gear does not get in the way of that whatsoever, which is nice. Standard T-hooks at the hip and waist. These leg things kind of do get in the way a little bit there, but you can always move them up and down to do whatever you need to, so no big deal there. Still full front and back motion. We do have a double knee joint there, and standard swivel and rocker there at the ankle. So all in all, really great articulation on this guy. He's a cool figure. I've always liked this particular sculpt, and the color scheme actually works pretty well for this one. So yeah, I'm actually really happy with this guy. So there you have it. That is all three of these figures from the G.I. Joe Tactical Ninja Team. It's a bit of a misnomer because they're not all ninjas. I don't really know. Yeah, I'm not going to get into that, actually. So we do get Sergeant Airborne. We get a cool Snake Eyes figure. We get Agent Mouse. It's a pretty interesting set. I think I like Airborne better than the rest of the figures. Snake Eyes works really well as a basic figure. I just really am put off by the web gear color choices. But, you know, if you can get past that, he's got a ton of accessories and it's a really good figure. Agent Mouse is a good generic trooper and does pretty good for what he is. And you get this crazy rappelling line attachment, so for that, I think it's a really good buy. Price on this stupid thing is a little bit higher than it should be. I'm assuming it's because of Agent Mouse that's included in the set, because we haven't really got too many figures of that character in the past. So I don't know that it's worth a premium for that particular figure, so I'm going to say no to that. But if you can find it for a decent price, definitely pick it up. I don't think you're going to be disappointed. It's got three really good figures in it. Just not three outstanding figures, I guess, would be the best way of saying it. So, do with that what you will. Make your choices and, yeah, there we go. That's all the time we've got for today, so thanks for watching. Drop some comments down below. Let us know what you think of the G.I. Joe Tactical Ninja Team from the Retaliation line. Do you have a favorite figure out of this set? What do you think about the Agent Mouse figure? Does it actually look like David Duchovny to you? It does. It's David Duchovny. I swear. Doesn't look like that with the helmet off, though. Come on, pull your helmet off. That's not David Duchovny. But that is. That's just weird. Anyways, if you haven't already, feel free to subscribe to our channel. Be on the lookout for more awesome videos coming down the pipeline. Check out some of our previous videos to see more of these cool G.I. Joe action figures. And until next time, Yo, Joe.